friends. Welcome to Knitography. I'm Patricia, and I'm coming to you this week from the city of Trondheim. I'm standing outside of Vår Frue Kirke to tell you a most beautiful and inspirational knitting story. Last week, I told you the story of Berit Aune, a Norwegian woman that immigrated into America. She began a mission federation with her knitting to build a church, to hire a teacher, and to start a school for the children of her community. This got me thinking about my own community in Trondheim and this very special church behind me. In our city, there is a mission federation called Bymission, and they have started the most wonderful knitting story of all. This story happens every year, and its message, I hope, will inspire you, especially in today's political climate. If you haven't guessed, the color is orange, and it's all about a knitted orange scarf. Berit Aune used her selbuvotter to start her federation to build a Lutheran church in Minnesota, much like the Vår Frue church that we see here today. But the story of the orange scarf actually begins in the capital of Norway, Oslo. In 2010, a group of hand knitters got together, much like a husflidenslag, to have an exhibition to show the tradition of making in Norway. Within this exhibition, they hung up a group of blankets. I can't imagine what these blankets must have looked like, but I know for certain that they would have been beautiful, they would have been made of wool, and they would have been warm. And during the exhibition, this group of makers began to notice something strange about the blankets. They began to notice that they were hung differently when they would arrive the next day. And in the end, this group of makers realized that their blankets were being used during the night. Well, they were being used during the night by people that were sleeping outside in the cold. And so they would use the blankets during the night and then gingerly hang them up the next day. As you can imagine, the discovery that these beautiful blankets were being used during the night and then returned each morning would have been very moving to these makers. And so they discussed this and decided that this was something that they needed to take action for and do something important within their community for the very cold winter nights in Norway. They contacted the Bymission, which is the city mission organization within Norway. And they worked together in a collaboration with the Bymission to create the orange scarf. The orange scarf is orange because the Bymission's logo is the color of orange. And the color of orange is a strong color. It's a color that would send a message of inclusion, community, and warmth to the people that they would create these scarves for. And so in 2011, this group of makers knit the first orange scarves in collaboration with the Bymission. The Bymission helped this group of makers have the opportunity to place these scarves in and around the city so that those that needed them most could simply take them on the coldest nights of winter. As you can imagine, the idea of the orange scarf began to spread throughout Norway. The makers and the Bymission realized that this was a bigger need, possibly, than they had imagined. Now, as I told you, they were hung up within the city of Oslo for anyone to take that needed it to be physically warm at night. But this message was bigger than just physical warmth. This message was about joy, about inclusion, about a people that were suffering the most during the coldest part of winter, to feel that there was someone reaching out to them, that there was some way that they were included within the community. And so the Bymission began to rethink the message that they wanted to send with the orange scarf. They began to think that this could be a symbol that everyone could wear about a warmer community, about a warm and open society. And so it began the next year that they would ask people on the streets as well as people within the cities to wear these scarves during the coldest part of winter as a symbol of warmth, inclusion, and community. November 1st is the day that these scarves are shared throughout cities. In my city, on November 1st, they're hung on statues, they're hung on poles, they're hung in malls, they're hung on gates, they're hung on bridges for anyone to take. And the people of the Bymission stand in and around the city to ask those walking past if they would be willing to support the idea of wearing the scarf during this period of time leading up to Christmas. This is the darkest time of the year, the coldest time of the year, and the time when they deem the warmest day of the year, November 1st. And now in 2016, the idea of the orange scarf has spread throughout my city. 1,000 scarves were knit last year with the idea that the orange scarf is not something that we knit for others. It is something that we knit and do for each other and for our community. In the whole of Norway, 10,000 scarves were knit last year, hung up within many cities across our country, and distributed by the Bymission themselves. The work that the Bymission does within our city is something that is so important. The color of orange is a strong one. The message it sends of inclusion, community, openness is an important one. This church behind me is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for any and all who need it. So I have now repositioned myself to stand at a different location of the church, especially to show you the beautiful windows on its facade. So I was telling you a bit about the color of the scarf and that it was connected to the color of the logo of the Bymission, which is orange. Orange, again, is a strong color. It sends a strong message, and the work of the Bymission is very important, and they wanted to send a strong message with this action they were taking with the orange scarf. This is the basic pattern. It comes with a Bymission tag and also these sieve tags. I'm going to tell you something very special about these tags as well. Before though, I want to tell you that again, November the 1st is when all of these scarves are hung up within my city on statues, on bridges, and all of the places that I have named. But they are distributed throughout the day until they are all given out. During this time of year, you will find it to be the darkest time of year in the middle of Norway. We have approximately 35 to 45 minutes of what you might call dusk light. So it is very, very dark indeed. This is a difficult time for many people, especially with the upcoming celebrations and the holiday of Christmas. For many people that struggle, this is a difficult time. And so the message of the Bymission is one of to bring joy to people that are really not looking forward to the Christmas season. People that might have lost a loved one or for the first time without them, don't have family to share, or there are so many reasons that people might not enjoy the Christmas or the holiday season. So this is why the Bymission especially wants to give these scarves out for people to bring them some warmth and some joy as the season is approaching. And so November the 1st has been deemed the warmest day of the year here in Trondheim and in cities throughout Norway. What's extraordinary about the work of these scarves is that they are not really advertised. You don't really see the Bymission asking people to knit these scarves or join into the action. This actually spreads by knitters. So knitters tell other knitters and they join in, and it just has spread this way. It's not an advertised action. And of course, the people wearing them encourages the participation in the project as well. So it just exploded through word of mouth. As people began to find out what the orange scarf action was all about, it's just grown from year to year. And as I shared earlier, 10,000 scarves were knit last year, and 1,000 scarves were knit within my city of Trondheim. Now, as you can imagine, a knitter can only knit so many scarves themselves, but really, they're knit with so much care and so much thought and so much purpose during the knitting that it just becomes a symbol of our community standing shoulder to shoulder and for each other. So when a knitter has knit their limited number of scarves during the knitting, they are creating a warmth within the community that really can never end. I want to tell you a most beautiful story about the scarf that really touched me in digging deeper into the story, but also in finding out about the people that made them. And also this idea of struggling during the darkest time of the year. Now, if you noticed, I showed you this little tag that is sewn on that shows that it is a project of the Bymission. Now, normally when you would sew on this tag, you would sew on the corners of the tag. You would just attach the tag to the item in the corners, and that would be that. But what the Bymission discovered was that people were stitching all around the edges of the tag, and they were inserting secret messages. And some of the secret messages that I read, I have to tell you, moved me to tears. In exploring this project, and also finding out deeper the stories that were connected to this simple orange scarf, I was very moved. I read a message of a girl that had lost her brother, and she hoped that the person that would receive this would accept it in his honor. People that struggled at Christmas time, who had no one to buy a gift for, said that it had brought them so much joy to knit this. It would be their only gift for someone that they could give. So the messages were about the meaning of knitting this scarf for the recipient. And I found that to be truly beautiful and inspiring. The other story that I was told is that there is a lady within my city. Her daughter came into the Bymission and told that her mother had been a beautiful knitter throughout her life. But unfortunately, in her 90s, she became blind. And she wasn't unable to see anymore to do her knitting. But her daughter came in to get the yarn for her to participate in the knitting of these scarves. Because, of course, as you know, this simple garter stitch, the back and forth, we can often do it without looking at it. And so she helped her mother to become a part of this project, and this woman at 92 years old sends 20 or 30 of these scarves a year to the project, and she is completely blind. So that is a most beautiful story from the Bymission that they told me during my research. Hello friends, I'm back home now. I'm sitting on our front porch. This is the entrance to our home, and on the front we have a little bench that's built into the wall of the house that you can just come out and sit on and overlook down the mountain to Selbusjen. But I had to leave Trondheim because it was starting to rain and to get very cold. You might have noticed in the previous video, my makeup was beginning to run and I was getting quite cold. So I came home and I just thought I would finish up this week's vlog from my front porch. It has cleared up here quite a lot. It's a bit breezy, but if you were able to hear, you could hear the creek running in the back of our house. It is, the melt is on, and it is an amazing sound coming from the creek at this time of year. It's just full and rushing down the mountain. So I made myself a cup of coffee, and the first thing that I wanted to share with you is that I'm having it out of my Starbucks Trondheim cup. And so on the cup is the cathedral, which is an exciting adventure that we will be taking in the future. I'll be taking you to the cathedral. But one of the things you might notice about the Trondheim cup is that it is orange. I always wondered why the Trondheim cup was orange. I thought it was a strange color to be chosen for our Starbucks cup because of the trended colors of the Bunad, which is typically blue. So I investigated this, of course, and asked many questions and was astonished to find out that it was, as I have told you, orange because of the message of the Bymission, the symbolism of the orange scarf, an inclusive community, a welcoming community, and an open community. So having this cup means all the more to me. Inside is also just completely orange. So that is another beautiful connection to the story that I wanted to tell you today. So the Bymission does a lot of work. They do lots of work, and it's all connected to handwork and craft. So while I was there visiting the Bymission and having a tour and also looking at the things that they have for sale there, I did take some video, which I will attach to this vlog, and you will see that they have a blanket project, they have a very special brooch project that is beautiful, the story to that is very beautiful, they have a stationery project that they make from recycled papers, and yeah, they had many projects, which I did video very closely so that you might see. You might, you know, wonder about the Bymission. It is a church. Of course, there are Christian values connected to this work. But I want to tell you that the most wonderful thing about Norway is that all religions, all creeds, all nationalities, and all people from around the world are very accepted here. We do not have these struggles with feelings with immigrants or things that my country is struggling with, especially in the political climate of today. One of the most wonderful things is that although Norway does have ways in which people are going to come into the society, that is their message, that they shall come into the society. They will be supported to come in, and there's education for the people and for learning the language. And I think it is one of the reasons why I wanted to share this knitting story with you so desperately, because of what is happening in my own country and how such a small act of handwork, a knitted piece, can mean so much as a symbol, as a message, not only in Norway, but to the world about our beliefs, about people, about inclusion, and about having an open and warm society. And that is definitely what I think that people feel within our city. I wanted to tell you one other beautiful project that the Bymission does. It doesn't have to do anything with knitting, but it is always meant so, so very much to me. And it comes in this little box. If you ever purchase it, it comes in this tiny little box, and inside the box is a little bit of straw that can help protect this object. And there is a picture of the Frue Kirke, the heart of the Bymission. And inside are these little glass angels. Now, this one is orange. I chose an orange one to tell this story. It is painted, and this is made out of recycled glass. It is broken glass. It starts as broken glass, and then it is crafted into these beautiful little symbols of angels. Now, at Christmas time, they're clear. I have many of the clear ones with little hearts. The symbol of Christmas here in Norway is a heart, and they have little hearts on them. But this one is orange to represent the project of the orange scarf and the community. And so this little angel is a inclusive, welcoming, open society angel. And he or she is made of orange paint and broken glass. Now, the story of these angels is extremely touching. And if you're needing this story today, I hope that you will receive it with the warmest greetings from me, because this story means an awful lot to me on so many levels. But inside the little box, you get a little card like this, and I'm just going to translate it, and I hope it won't be too choppy, but it's called a glass angel from Trondheim. So this angel is from the city of Trondheim. And it says, "This angel is made of glass, of broken glass. The Bymission wishes that this angel would be a memory that anything that has gone into pieces or is broken into pieces can be put back together new and beautiful." And the sale of these angels goes to the work of the Bymission. Now, You might think, especially if you come from my part of the world in America, you know, we often wonder about this money and where it goes. But I would like you to know that the money that goes to the Bymission goes right to the people that need it. These people that the scarves were knit for originally. People that are struggling with addiction, people that are completely alone, people that are, it's a lot of emotional struggle. It's a lot of societal struggle with family relationships or being alone. I'll tell you that. But one of the things that they do is they provide meals every, first of all, the church is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and you can come in there. It does not matter your economic level, or it doesn't matter what you're struggling with. If you need a quiet place of meditation or a place of solace, then this church is open for you. And the other thing is, they provide support and meals, warm meals, to those people that need it for no cost at all. And so the wonderful action that they have with the orange scarf is, as I said, they provide support during this darkest time of the year, and they provide Christmas. They have on Christmas Eve, the time of the year when we celebrate Christmas Eve, the church is completely open. Anyone can come. Anyone can eat, sing, partake in the Christmas story. It is a wonderful experience. I have not done Christmas the traditional way, and my family and I have volunteered there, and we have participated there many years that we have been in Trondheim. It's very important for me and that my children see that Christmas is about giving of yourself and also the kinds of people that need support within our community. And the other thing is that on Thursday nights, the meals are distributed and made by the youth within our city that are going to be confirmated in the spring. So right now on Thursday night when I visited the church, there were the young people getting the meal ready to serve to these people that need it the most within our city. And both of my children have also participated in this project. It is a very enriching thing that they have participated in. So I wanted to just conclude by telling you a little bit about the angel, and also the meals that they provide, where this money actually goes. And what's really lovely is you can just send a text message to this telephone number, and you can buy dinners along as you feel that you can, or you feel compelled to contribute to this project. So you know that the money is going to your community, and you know that it's going to help people that you are shoulder to shoulder with, and that is one of the most wonderful contributions that I enjoy making for my community. Now, I have been digging in my stash for some more orange yarn. Now, I have dug this out because I have also contributed to the knitting of scarves. And one of the things that I wanted to tell you is this project is usually starting in October, and people are knitting, and then there's a deadline like the end of October to turn in the scarves ready to be distributed on November the 1st. So I have to say, that's a busy time for me at school, and most of my scarves are knit in the summer because it's a lightweight project that I can do, you know, at the cabin, sitting outside. You don't get too warm, and so most of my scarves that I donate are knit during the summer. I do knit a few in the autumn, but this summer I will be knitting lots of the orange scarves, and I've already dug out my wool to take with me to the cabin where I'll be spending my summer this year. So I want to tell you that I will be donating through the Bymission, or sponsoring with the Bymission. I will be giving away an orange scarf. I'm also going to be giving away this wonderful, key holder. Is it called a lancet or something like that? And it's a beautiful message on it in Norwegian that says, "No one is just what you see." And I absolutely think that this is a wonderful thing that we can share that message. No one is what you see or what they seem. It's difficult for me to translate it exactly in English, but ingen er bare det du ser. And in Norwegian, it just gets right to the point and right to your heart. And I have that. And also, I'll be giving away one of these city angels. Now, I'll be posting that on my project page, and what I would like you to do is I would like you to go and tell me a knitting story like the one that I've told you. Do you know a knitting story in which someone has been deeply affected by the piece that you've given them? Has it created a more open relationship between the giver and the recipient? I would also like to know of a project, a knitting project, a charity project that is helping other people. These are the kinds of things that I would like you to think about and possibly share as a comment on my project page when I get it uploaded. I would love to hear these stories. I think people that visit the project page might enjoy also reading them. Now, speaking of my project page, you can find the link to my project page on my Instagram feed. If you click on P Fortune, P4CHEN, you will see the link to my project page. My project page is a project page. It is about bringing stories, knitting stories, meaningful to you through these vlogs. And I know myself, from the messages that I have received, that many people are sharing these stories with other people, and that means more to me than I can express. I would also like to say thank you so much for those of you that went to the project page to donate to my project. It has meant a lot. I have received several donations since I shared the project page, and all of those donations will go back into the project so that I can keep researching and get access. So I really appreciate that. The last thing I want to share is I want to tell you that I was so excited this week that my logo is up on my project page now. My logo is very connected to my project. It's about traveling around. It's about telling stories. It's about knitting. And it's about bringing visual images through video and photography directly to those of you that visit my vlog. A very dear friend of mine, artist friend, took a simple drawing that I made and she brought that image to life. So I thank you for your feedback and your kindness about my logo, and I hope you enjoy seeing it on my project page, and you're going to see it on some very, very special items connected to my project coming soon. This week, I have no knitting to show you at all because I am still working on my cardigan. My cardigan is going so well. I have taken lots of photos of the progress on Instagram, and I hope you've seen it there. I am on my sleeves. I'm really going to be working on finishing my sleeves this week because on Friday we travel to the sea, and I will put all of that aside to be knitting my skulgafjell jumper. I showed the pattern in the last vlog. So I will take a break from the knitting of my rusty cardigan and I will move to something that is very spring-like and very inspiring that I will take to the cabin. I will be bringing you life at the cabin in my upcoming vlog. I'm taking a little bit of a break as we move into the next room of the Selbuvalte, because in that room it's very much about the Industrial Revolution, knitting machines, the Olympics, and all of that. And I think it's a good time to take a break within the book, the Selbuvalte book, and to just take a break from there and focus on the idea of Easter in Norway. I'm going to try to bring you what Easter feels like as much as possible through my upcoming vlog. And also, of course, it'll be more about my knitting because that's what I'll be doing. I'll be vlogging possibly more frequently every other day from the cabin. So I hope that that will bring you some joy during the Easter break or the spring break. So, with that, I really hope you enjoyed the story of my city, the beautiful knitting story of the orange scarf. If you have any questions or wonders, please get in contact with me through Instagram or Ravelry messages, but especially through my project page in the comments there. I hope to have the giveaway up in the next day or two, but I will announce that on Instagram to alert you to go to the project page and join in for the giveaway of the scarf and the glass angel and the lancet, and also some yarn for those of you that might be very inspired to knit an orange scarf. And having said that, if you are interested in knitting some orange scarves for this project, you can contact me. Those can be knit any time in the upcoming months to be distributed on November 1st if you would like to get involved with that project here in Norway. I would love to say that some of the people in my knitting community contributed to such a project. The pattern is available, and I can translate that into English if needed. So, from the middle of Norway, the city of Trondheim, the city of Orange in all its glory, have a wonderful week, and I will see you the next time from the sea.